All right. So welcome everyone to our GEMS College of Energy Medicine first anniversary party. And we are very excited to all be here together. And we've got a neat little program set up for you today so that we have a chance to connect and to be able to do some self-balancing, to see some new material, to play a game together. And you have to forgive me because I'm just letting people in also as they're showing up. So if I pause for a second, that's probably what's going on. I'm expecting a few people to kind of be dropping in as we are getting going today. But we're really glad that you can join us. And this has been a really interesting year for us. You know, we kind of just launched last January. But as a lot of you know, because of the nature of the way that things work in our industry, often things are kind of booked a year ahead. And so, and so this, even though we've had a year of doing everything with this college, it's like this next year, I think, is our first opportunity to really kind of jump in an intentional way where we're scheduling things in a very deliberate way for this community. And everyone who's here has been a part of that, which has been amazing. So I'm going to stop babbling for a second here and just let Hannah go ahead because she's prepared a few things for us to kind of remind us of what we've done in the last year.
Thank you. Let me screen share now that we've figured out all the settings. Because I know that sometimes it can be easy for us to kind of get caught up in all of that, like everything that's happened in the first year and everything that hasn't happened in the first year. And it's important for us to remember to celebrate the things that we have actually achieved and all the things that have happened and the connections that we've made. And so some people kind of were with us last year. We started with a very clear vision about what we wanted this to look like, and that we wanted this to be not just another place to list classes, but a community and a network of instructors with, you know, paths for effective learning and chances to share knowledge and to kind of do this together, right? Outside of just being in workshops. So we kind of had this this plan for thematic learning. And those of you who have been here this whole last year remember when we launched like study hall and yoga class and book club and program consulting and all of these things to really kind of encourage that kind of learning and this path that we're on together. So that being said, I've looked back over the calendar and we have over 70 study hall hours, some of which, you know, were guest stars on a specific topic, which we now have on the YouTube channel. Some of which were amazing connection opportunities for us and for, you know, various students and fellow practitioners. And some of them were just us sitting at the kitchen table yelling at the website. But, you know, they're all here. And it's, I still think it's such a really important time that we've set aside for this collaboration, right? This time for us to do even the boring website stuff together. We've also logged about 25 yoga classes with Liz, which I'm so happy about. They've been so amazing. She manages to every time come up with new ways to combine touch for health and yoga and energy work and make it all come together for amazing balance for those of us who show up. And I would really encourage everyone else to show up, honestly. She's amazing, and it's free for members. The first one's free either way, and then you can have a drop-in if you want. I'm just saying, absolutely worth the next 25. Going back to the calendar, I also realized we have sponsored over 40 workshops and events this year, which is crazy. That's 8 different modalities. And that's not even including things like the pendulum workshop, which isn't really its own modality, or including, you know, events that we have been partnered with Nolative to help support, things like their masterclass and the Youth Holistic Health Summit, all fall in here as well. And those 40 workshops and events have happened with more than 10 different instructors around the world. That being said, I have had a lot of people actually contact the college looking for classes, which is exciting. And it's a sign to me that these things are working. And anyone who is interested in becoming one of these instructors, we really want to expand this network at this point. That's one of my goals for this year for the college. So please do contact us, or we are planning on sending out emails in the near future about our instructor memberships, because I really want to be able to be sending new students into everyone's classes as they're contacting us, looking for their best options. And I just wanted to put this in here because I think, again, one of the important things that we have written so much about, and that is sort of one of those core values of this business, is the resources and the chance to share knowledge and to just sort of be in this together, right? So those of you who haven't kind of explored it yet, the YouTube channel has lots of interviews with, you know, course creators in our field and mini balances, and all of our free intro kind of workshops from the last year are all on here. And any other resources that you are looking for that you can't find, let us know. Let's keep making these things available for all of us to learn more. Now, last year we had asked people this at our grand opening celebration. We had asked what people's resolutions or goals for this last year were. These are some of the answers that we got during that meeting. You know, people working on their own health, working on their business, leading with grace, and, you know, getting through their lists more and less of whatever they need in their life at this time. And I would like to take this opportunity right now to first of all ask if anyone who made a goal like this last year with us or otherwise, how that has gone for you. If you feel like you've been really able to achieve it, if you feel like you're still working on it. And then what's new? What are we working on this year? What are we kind of working towards, again, as a community and individually? So if there's a few people who want to talk and reflect on these at this time, you can. If you want to put something in the chat, you can. I'm gonna stop this. Thank you.
I'll go first, because I'm so proud of both of you and everything that you've accomplished. It's been such an honor to be part of this and to be included in, you know, being someone who gets to present my work through the college. And as you know, like SIPS is my thing, and I integrate it into everything I do. So I'm so grateful, and to watch it grow and to be part of like the growth forward. I think that's my biggest goal. This last year, I really took a lot of time and space. I had change all around in my life, but I really took the time and space to organize my own work, my own business assets and everything. And I feel like I finally have this stable table that I'm sort of, now I can dance on it. And so my one goal for the year is like just epic, expansive growth in my own work, goal number two is my health, and goal number three is fun. I want to, I'm not a fun person by nature, so I really want to explore that. So I'm so happy to be part of this community. It just, it means so much. And Hannah and I get to chill many Wednesday mornings for study hall and just like do nerdy work things. And it's just, it's nice knowing that as someone who works from home, that I'm not by myself all the time. So congratulations. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you. But also I love how you just said, I'm going to create a stable table so that I can dance on it. And then said, I'm not a fun person.
I am becoming a fun person. Yeah.
We are here for it. We are on this journey. Thank you, Kasia, because we love having your classes and doing nerdy things on Wednesday mornings.
I'd like to say something. Congratulations to the college on a full year and everything that was accomplished through the hard work of everybody behind the scenes and everybody doing the teaching and the taking of the classes. And I have a goal for this next year to simultaneously get more grounded and also more metaphysical at the same time, to like push myself to be taller, I guess, you know, in a sense, like push all of my amazing things forward, but go just as far down into groundedness as I'm going up. So my goal is to really feel those two polar ends and use them to stabilize everything.
I was being quiet so that Hannah had the opportunity to keep leading here, but apparently she's done. anybody
sorry,
else?
I'm trying to write down people's goals so I can do the same thing to you all next year.
Excellent.
She's done magnificently. In any way, if I might jump in. I have changed my life completely in 2020, 2019, like to the depth I haven't imagined, and followed my heart. And now I'm reorganizing my assets as well. So it's probably a year of reorganization for me. And I'm sort of combining my own energy work, the energy work and everything that actually you, Alexis, teach me. And I'm also one of the persons that is redoing the scripts for my own purposes. So this is, for example, steps 3, 4, and 5, so that all the material could be more accessible, like to me, understandable, and so that I could work with people more comprehensively, like from the point of where I understand the system and I can help more efficiently. And the third thing is I work astrologically as well, so I do see further processes I'm trying to fit into them myself. So these are actually the broader goals to put this all together and to create like a real project out of that, and I'm on the way with that. And the other side of the thing is joy. I also want to have more joy in my life, so I can subscribe to everything that's been said, and I'm actively working towards that. So that would be like my broad overview of the year that's been that has just started. And thank you very much for letting me be a part of your community, because I think, this is incredible, because I need this sort of a thing. And I think I have connected with you. I appreciate all that you have been doing. And I think it's a lot of work, to be honest. It's going to pay off, but it's going to probably take some more time. But the things that you have been doing, I think it's incredible. It's super. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Happy
anniversary.
I'm with you. You can't really see it on the screen, but I'm wearing my fire element shirt today, which says joy across the back.
Joy, yes.
And that's to fit in, because Liz's theme for our yoga class tonight is all about like heart and joy and celebration and fire energy. So it's to all go together with that. Thank you. Carolina's in Poland, and it was so lovely to be able to, we had been doing classes together online for a couple of years. And then this last October, I actually got to go to Warsaw and teach class there. And so I got to walk in and see people who I had been communicating with online for years. And it was like just the most incredible thing. Thank you.
It was fantastic.
All right. Anybody else want to share anything about their resolutions from last year or for this next year before we launch into the next bit? Liz.
I wanted to share my vision board. So Nancy and I did a breath work workshop right before the new year. And it was really transformational. And I really saw the vision like of the next year, bringing in a lot of magic into life and allowing magic and not holding back any magic. And so I wanted to show you this is my vision board for the next year, which really is, it's just a lot of pictures of nature and beauty and rainbows and just allowing for the beauty of and light to come through. And I know that's not a very specific goal, but it's just like letting go of any more restrictions I have around just letting myself shine through. And wanting to thank GEMS College just for kind of asking me to show up in those ways too. So teaching pendulum classes and teaching yoga and just creating the space for me to hold me, to share what I can share with my community and the worldwide community here. So thank you. I just feel like GEMS is the school of magic.
Thank you.
And we love having you. Thank you for teaching things.
Yeah, I'm so grateful that I get to work with you all because, I mean, some of you know me better than others in this group. My inclination is always just to do things myself, right? If something needs done, I'll just do it myself. It's easier, it's faster. Then it's done exactly the way that I think it should be done, and we're over it. And to realize that not only did I not have to do this myself because the vision that I had was so much bigger than me, but that it would be so much better to not, right? Like it would be so much better to bring in other people that are better at these other things than I am. It would be so much better to work in a community so that we can mirror the goals and the intentions and everything that we have for the greater community. It was hard to kind of break out of that old mindset into something new. And so I'm really, really grateful that I get to hang out with you all and make it work in this very fascinating way. Okay, if there's no other, or I guess I should ask and not assume, are there any other affirmations or resolutions or anything from last year or for this next year that anyone wants to share before we move into the next bit?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'll just say really quickly, I think mine was last year was the last one on that slide was about like being loudly and grandly myself. And I wouldn't say grandly, but I would say that I made big progress on that in the last year. And it is going to be the same thing this year in like being really confident and stepping forward into things that I care about and not holding myself back. Liz said something about like letting go of the restrictions of myself and just letting magic happen. Like I'm with you on that. So.
Hannah, we have heard your voice this year in a way that we haven't before. It's been good. Cool. Okay. So some of you have shared some ideas of what you want to be working on and focusing on for this next year. Some of you haven't, but hopefully you still have something kind of in your head as what you want to be bringing more of into your life and how you want to be focusing your energy for 2023. We were going to use that idea of working with resolutions or affirmations or however you want to think of it to do a little like self-balance. And so this is like a sneak peek of material for from the GEMS Archetypes and Elements class that we're going to be doing next month for the first time. Did any of you see the little video that I popped up with the sounds yesterday? Okay, a couple of yes, mostly no. So this is going to be new, which is great. So give me 1 second. I'm just going to share my screen here. Okay. Can everyone see that okay? Excellent. All right. So we're going to just do this as a really quick little self-balance kind of technique. But most of you are familiar with the idea of doing a five-element sound balance. This is a concept from Touch for Health. And every element we know has its own colors, its own emotions, its own season, its own taste, all of these things that go along with it. But they also each have their own sound. And as someone who's been teaching Touch for Health for a really long time, sound balancing is a really powerful technique that also there's often a lot of resistance to. When we do sound balancing in class, people get very self-conscious. People don't like making the sounds, right? There's a lot of emotion that's wrapped up in it. And you'll hear more with this balance than with any other balance, I think. You'll hear people say things, well, like, I never shout. I can't cry. I don't do that, right? But it's because it speaks to us on such a primal level. And that ability to move that energy on this really primal level is important and it's profound. So the basic sounds that go along with the five elements, again, this is a little bit of a review. We know that wood, the sound is a shout. Fire is laughter. Earth is to sing. Metal is to cry or a deep sigh. And water is to groan. Now, obviously, some of these people have more resistance to than others. Like, it's not usually hard to get people to laugh in class, but to get people to make a sound like a groan can be tricky. So this class that I've been working on and obsessing about for the last year, working with the archetypes, we're bringing in the principal archetypes from Jungian psychology, correlating them with specific elements, with chakras, with separate from the tree of life, with stages of the reproductive life cycle, with all of these things. And we're working with energetic patterns on a really deep and primal kind of level. And so it popped into my head as I was working with this, that one of the ways that we could do this was with the sound. And so the actual balance, when we do it in class, we're going to be really considering how each of the archetypes would use that sound to further their own needs and goals, right? So for instance, in the wood element, we know that the sound is a shout. If we were looking at this on the archetype spectrum, that's the archetype of the maiden and warrior. And so we're looking at the yin-yang aspects and that spectrum of personality. And what that archetype needs is to find some independence, to find some autonomy, to set boundaries, to be growing, right? So what we've got here is not just a shout, but it's a shout to convey a boundary, right? It's a stop, it's a get back, it's a battle cry, right? So that's what I've done here is kind of look at a deeper way of expressing each of these sounds so that it brings up whatever energy we need. So if we were going to be doing this in class, we would muscle test for, you know, which is the prime element that really needs to be expressed right now, right? If you are good at self-testing, what I would suggest that we do for a moment is just think about your resolution or your affirmation or your theme or whatever it is for this next year. And, you know, just start by maybe doing a bit of a self-assessment, as we often do in kinesiology classes. So thinking about, how stressful does that feel on a scale of 1 to 10? How doable does that feel? How true is that statement? You know, whatever, whatever scale, whatever question makes sense for you right now. And what we're going to do is just look quickly at each one of these sounds in turn. And then we're going to look at a little video where you can either express them all in a row and let the energy move through the circle, or you can express the one that muscle tests for you as the most advantageous at this moment. Does that make sense? Okay, so if we kind of look at this, I already mentioned this one, the wood element, the maiden, the warrior. This is about shouting with conviction. This is about setting boundaries. Get back, leave me alone, a battle cry, a warning. Right? And just think, does that energy apply to this resolution, this affirmation that I have? Fire, in my class, I've actually put the wood and fire elements together, so they are both related to the maiden and warrior. And if you were in class, we'll talk about why. But at this point, just looking at the fire element, the sound is laughter. And so we're looking at not just laughter, but a big exclamation of laughter to whoop with joy, right? I'm thinking of the kind of sound that you would make as you were doing something crazy or wild or doing something that is a physical expression. The earth element goes along with the mother lover archetype spectrum. And so it is to sing, but we're singing with affiliation, as in the singing is about bringing us together. It's a song of togetherness. So this might be a lullaby, or this might be a teaching song. I'm thinking of a teacher, you know, clapping out a rhythm for the students in order to give them something that brings them together and teaches them something. Or like a choir, an anthem, where you would have thousands of people maybe all singing the same words at the same time. I love song. Then we have the metal element, which is related to the queen-king spectrum. So it is sighing or crying, but there's also this idea of release that comes with it. Letting go of whatever is not needed. And so again, if this applies to your affirmation, to your resolution, you can even put that word in there. I release fear. I release doubt. I release pain, whatever it is. There's also that idea of breathing in inspiration. So inspiration means to breathe in, right? But we also think of inspiration as being what elevates us, what gives us a bigger purpose. And we breathe out what is expired. Expiring is an exhalation. Get rid of it. I was also thinking of the idea of a town crier, right? So, I mean, yeah, this is a play on words. But, you know, often the queen or king would send out their declaration with someone else who would have to shout it in the middle of the square so that everyone would hear, right? Is the message getting across? And then lastly, we have the wise woman or the magician archetype, which goes along with the water element. And again, you know, in Touch for Health classes, I find groaning one of the hardest ones to get people to actually do. And what came up here was to groan with judgment. And what I mean by that is you can make the sound that sort of shows this is not what we want. We're not in agreement with this thing. We are able to express ourselves without inhibition, just not caring what anybody else thinks, right? As another note, a groan sound often goes along with pain. And when we are looking at this archetype, you know, as this is sort of the finishing of a cycle, we often do associate this with being older, right? If you have an affirmation or resolution that has to do with getting rid of pain, if you're also finding that you're making a sound as you sit down or as you get up these days, right? That can kind of be part of the release of this stuck energy and allow us to kind of move it through. So hopefully at least one of those kind of resonated with you and you have an idea in your head. I'm going to put on a little video that's going to show each one of these in turn, and it's also going to show a little clip of somebody making this sound. My intention is that we are all going to turn off our microphones and make the sound ourselves. But even if you don't, even watching somebody make the sound, even if you can't hear it, should sort of cause some resonant frequency for you. But ideally, you're going to make the sound. And the only reason why I'm not doing it too is because I don't want to mess with the video. So, I'm going to do it, but I'm not going to do it with the microphone on is what I mean. Okay, are we ready? So let's go ahead and turn this on. And there's a little bit of soft music with it. If, you know, a couple seconds in, you're not hearing anything, somebody let me know, okay? All right. It's not working when I hit the play button for reasons I don't understand. One second, I can fix this. Because I, knowing that my tech won't work for me, have a backup plan.
Plan B.
All right, let's try this one and see what happens. All right. So hopefully that was interesting, at least. It's a little faster than we would do it in real life. But it felt like we needed to get through it reasonably quickly today.
I had fun.
So Ugh. I don't know what it is about this slide. I'm trying to just move past it now and it doesn't want to let me. So that's fine. We don't need to go back into that. At any rate, I'm curious if there's any feedback, if anybody has anything they would like to share about going through that. Did you make the sounds or did you just cheat? Okay, Jor made the video big over here so I couldn't see anyone. So I didn't know if anyone's mouth was moving or not, but yeah. For me, I don't know. I think it's partly just the quality of the video, but when we get to the metal one and she takes that breath, every time I watched it, even when I was putting it together, I could just feel everything in my body be like, oh yeah. Okay.
I really enjoyed that. I feel very grounded and present as a result of having expressed myself. And did you want to say anything about that?
Yeah, it was fun. The singing together, we just like, it was really fun. But the other parts were a little awkward, like to do together, like what type of groaning are we? And so, but thinking about my goal afterwards, I felt a lightness to it that wasn't there before. It felt like more like an impossibility. And then thinking about it after, I just felt like more expansive around it. So that was cool.
I also appreciated the destigmatization of crying in the metal slide. I know that after my mom passed away for a good year, I was just weepy. And I think we have a negative connotation in our societies about crying, and that it's a weak thing to do, and that if somebody is crying, they're emotionally unstable. And that we should, you know, we should be able to handle everything without crying. And I really enjoyed the fact that it was destigmatized there.
Excellent, thank you.
Beautiful video, yeah.
Cool.
I liked that when we were doing wood, we got to yell and then we laughed about it, but then it immediately turned into fire. So that's perfect.
Yeah, we got to yell and we immediately laughed about it. That's the dream.
I really love that too. And I found the singing made me tear up. I definitely feel more grounded, like Liz said, about my goals, but I got the groaning with judgment down pat. Like I am an expert at that. So I can't wait for your class to figure that out.
Awesome. Yeah, in my head, I just think about my eyes roll when I do it. It's like, that kind of feeling, and it applies. All right. Amazing. Well, thanks for playing with me with this. This little video, as you saw, it's only a couple minutes long. It's up on YouTube. So if it feels like something that would be helpful to kind of play with or to give to your clients to play with or something like that, we'd love to hear from you, like your experiences and working with it as well. So thanks. And hopefully everyone's feeling good about their resolutions for 2023. And so then I'm going to hand this back to Hannah so that we can play a little game.
I like games.
Yes. Okay, Kasia, thanks for letting us know. Okay, last year when we did our grand opening celebration, Ezra led us in a five element scavenger hunt. And he is unfortunately working today, so I'm stuck playing games. I'm sorry, because he's much more fun. But I was thinking we would do something very similar, but instead of doing the five elements, using the chakras. So I've got, I'm just going to put a link here. I'm going to put this up on the screen as well. But since we have this like chakra basics document just free on the website, it's there if you want it. So I will put up the information for anyone who wants it. I will just read a couple of the keywords and then we will have like a minute to just run and find something that is, you know, the right color, the right feel to go with that chakra. And then we'll just share real quick. Okay. If that's kind of making sense, then I will share this. Okay. So I'm going to start. I'm going to start at root because it's the first one. So basic information about root chakra, color is red. This is about the physical and the musculature. This is grounding. This is ancestral energy. So objects that might go with this might be about bright color or might be something passed down or might be something really physical. Is everyone ready to scavenger hunt for our first object? Okay, I'm gonna set a timer and go. Okay, how's everyone doing? Can't see everyone. Most people are back. Right. Do people want to share the objects that they have grabbed? All right. See it later. I absolutely just cheated and grabbed my matching bio shirt. So I see Cash has also gone with fire. Yes, absolutely.
And do you want to turn off your screen share for a sec? Because then it can show everybody a little bit bigger. Okay, because then we can see everyone's things.
Yay.
I got tomatoes that are dirty. So they're both red and grounded.
Beautiful.
I got my meditation stool that it sits at the correct angle because that makes me feel really grounded. And this cinnabar quartz that I take everywhere with me in my pocket that is also red and is for the feeling of invincibility and helps me a lot.
Got my salt lamp, my little Himalayan salt lamp. It's, you know, from the earth and also warming.
I have an entire shelf of produce here, including tomatoes, ginger, and red onions.
Thank you for joining us from work.
Are you joining us from the cooler at back of Nature's Fair?
Cooler? No, staff room briefly.
Excellent. I'm in my office, so I have my root chakra spray. This is one of Evelyn Mulder's sound essence sprays. So,
okay, but you can't use your spray for all of them. That's cheating.
Well, I could use my spray for all of them, but I won't in order to not break your game.
I got my Spiderwit box set because it's red.
It is red.
Hi, everybody. I'm Mia. I'm actually driving, so I'm listening and enjoying all of this. And I just really wanted to adore Liz and so much that she brings into the world and just wanted to support her in the celebration. So I feel like a weird spider on the wall or like a wallflower, but I am paying attention and I just feel this celebration in so many ways. So just wanted to put that out there. It wasn't just like this like weird picture on your screen that was saying nothing. But that's how I'm driving. So I'm gonna go back off my talking.
I'm so glad you're here, Mia, and I love the picture of you. It looks so cool. I'm so glad you're here. Thank you for coming.
Thanks for popping in and saying hi, even though you're driving. We love Liz too, so.
Hi, Mia.
Thank you, Mia, for doing that, because you just encouraged me to do the same thing. I'm Tara, and I'm friends with Liz also, and so they invited me in here today from Vermont. I'm cold and chilly. I have red. It's my grounding blanket, so it really is. it represents the chakra well for me, because it really does keep me rooted. And I'm glad to be here. Congratulations on this really nice celebration. I'm also a Reiki practitioner and yoga teacher too, in a previous lifetime. So it's really nice to be around people who are carrying on those traditions and doing that where you live. Congratulations on the anniversary.
Thanks, Tara.
Thanks, Tara. Okay, did everyone?
I had to get a chance to see it, but it's okay. You don't see it properly. Red flowers, but artificial from here and from my agenda, from my calendar. It's cheating, but flowers make me very much grounded. So that's my first round. Thanks.
Not cheating at all. Flowers count. All right.
So I did not share yet. I am not holding anything, because you'll have to believe me, but I'm actually wearing red underwear. So
that's as root chakra as it gets, Kate.
Honestly.
I stood up to go get something, and then I was like, wait a second, I'm full on root chakra today. I'll just sit right back down. So
we will believe you, Kate.
Thanks.
I woke up this morning and it was just, I was going to put something else on and something just hit me. Red. I need red, red, red today. And I don't know why, but here I am. So now I know.
Sometimes it happens that way. All right. Is that everyone who wanted to share?
I will try to participate in the next round, but I am admittedly a little busy here. I begged to take a break early so that I could represent Air House briefly and say congratulations to Alexis and Hannah for their crowning achievement of the anniversary of their online college. Very well done.
We miss you.
All right, I'll shut up now.
Thanks for popping in just to see me fail at your game. All right. I will pop back over here so we can look at the next one. Sacral chakra. The color is orange. It is central. This is the seat of feminine energy. This is creative and passionate. So objects that fall in here might be really creative and inspired, or might be or frankly might be orange, but I'm gonna set my timer again. Is everyone ready? Okay. Go. That's time. I feel like most people are back. Okay, do people want to share what they've gathered for sacral chakra?
Can we just start by saying hi to Ruby May?
Yes, hi.
That's actually Rowan.
Hi. Oh, I haven't seen either of them in years, and my goodness, how big.
May's almost seven, and I went and got a child since the sacral is about reproduction.
We go to the gym.
Hey, Rowan, I'm sorry I confused you with your sister for a second there. I said I haven't seen either of you in like 3 years.
That happens all the time, doesn't it?
Well, we have lots of toys, but, and we also have this, and we also have this neighbor that's downstairs, and her name was Aspen.
That's right, yes.
And the neighbor right beside us is named Jim. And he gives us lots of toys, cars and toys to give us our track. Cars for us to drive the cars on.
My object I found is very loud.
No.
He just won the sacral chakra. I don't know what else to say.
This wasn't a competitive game, but I think Kate's winning. Hi, Danica.
Sorry. Quickly before my break is done, Danica says hi.
Hi, Danny.
Secondly, for my entry on this, I have an entire shelf of mandarina oranges. And also, let's see, this orange sweet potato salad.
Beautiful. Thank you for joining us.
All right, and I feel like that's enough of a tour of the cooler, so I'm actually going to head out, but good luck, guys, and thank you. See ya.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye,
Israel. I have my favorite singing bowl.
I feel like you and Cash are on like the same wavelength right now.
Usually.
Mine's a copper pot. I use it as my witchy cauldron where I burn things. And so it makes ashes. And then I put the ashes in my garden and they grow pretty things. So I figured that's as creative as it gets. And I have to go. So thank you. And it was lovely to see the faces that I know and meet some new faces. And I look forward to the next year.
Thanks for joining us, Kasia.
Bye.
I have this, which I made for my mom as a candle holder out of clay.
It's beautiful.
I don't know why I've never really liked the color orange. I guess because it doesn't look good on me. It looks terrible on me. So I'm like, what can I find? And it was funny. I went into my room and there was this little fairy that my kids got somewhere when they were little, and I love fairies because they're magic, and I love magic, so that was mine.
I do have tangerine essential oil, which I use for hormonal balances and for more joy as well, so probably that's not cheating this time. Thanks.
I have this. You are capable of amazing things. It's orange, and it signifies that creativity that we, you know, it's unlimited. And I also got our art supply bag with all of our oils and pencils and paints and markers in it. So this is just an infinite amount of creativity in here.
So I know that most of you guys are in your workspace. I'm right next to the kitchen. So I'm doing food-based themed things. I decided to go with passion. So I found an orange passion fruit. And that's what I've got. And I'm gonna eat this now because I'm also snacky.
Thank you for your contribution and also bring snacks. Anyone else wanting to share?
Do we want to pick one more chakra?
Yeah, we do. I grabbed
my little Arabrije from Mexico. Decided this is my feminine creative energy for today. My little owl. Okay, yeah, should we pick one more? Just for the sake of time, does anyone have a preference? Should I muscle test which one would be best?
Something colorful.
They're all colorful.
I know, that's the point.
Liz wants to do crown, yeah?
Yes, that fits with Nancy's statement before about, like, you know, we're gonna ground and then we're gonna go up. So,
all right. Okay, so we've created some foundation and then we'll go up. Crown. May as well just share this real quick. Though, of course, I put the link so we have this for anyone who wants it. Crown chakra. The color is violet. This is about the meaning of life and the connection with spirit, integration and balance and oneness. Okay. Are people feeling ready? No? I'm gonna set the timer anyways, okay? Go.
It's a terrible color for a kitchen.
Yeah, I don't know what to tell you. Give people a second to come back. All right. Okay, most people have come back. Does anyone want to share the object that they found for the crown chakra? Liz and Nancy are on it. You're like,
yeah. Well, we have a lot of toys to play with as well. So I found this awesome thing that is violet. It is a bunch of flowers made of what's this?
Felt
that my niece made for me. And beautiful. It's like a little flower thing, but it never goes bad and it sits by my bed. And it reminds me about how she and I are connected. And also I have a gorgeous polished amethyst rock that Liz gave me for Christmas, which again, makes me feel really connected.
And I have a piece of art that I got from a local artist. So, and it reminds me of every time I'm at Plum Island, which is in Eastern Massachusetts, the connection I feel to spirit when I'm right at the land between the ocean and the marshes, and just feeling totally like in my element there. So that's like a earth to heaven connection picture.
Who else would like to share?
I have this crystal, and this one was, it was a gift from one of my students in Russia, and it's hard to see, but there's a little crystal that's formed inside it. So it's like a mama crystal and a baby crystal, and it's creative, therefore. And this is one that I use for work when I need to hit an acupoint, like really specifically for some reason, or need to be sort of channeling energy specifically. And I grabbed this one because when I'm working is when I feel the most connected to that sort of universal energy and the most sort of plugged in to something bigger than myself. So this is my work thing. Do you want to show yours?
This one's mine. It's my mom's giant fairy book.
Yep. Dad, you're muted. Yeah, he's dead. you're muted though.
There we go. Bougainvillea flower, which happens to grow at head height. And if you brush up against the branches, you are definitely connected to them because of thorns. So that's my almost violet and connected.
Thank you for this contribution.
I do have a very simple thing. It's a paper file with my latest astrological work. So I basically connect through that to the universe at the very concrete level. Thanks.
That's great.
I will go. I grabbed two things. I grabbed a chunk of amethyst for the color, obviously, and because it's, you know, a crystal that connects us in. And I also grabbed my mala, because I have been doing mala mantras lately when I go to bed, and it's been really making me feel connected to more than just myself. So that's what I got.
Beautiful.
I was walking out of the room to go find something, and then I saw this. And this is just a blanket. It was actually my daughter's blanket, so that's a nice connection. And I use this all the time when I'm sitting in my office. And I thought, well, okay, that's kind of like, it's always there. It's part of my everyday. And that's kind of what God is like. So it made sense to me.
Beautiful. I also grabbed amethyst because that's what we all do. Got a pendulum as well as a Taishan kind of deal. And I also kind of on a whim grabbed, I have this picture and it's got the purple border. This is a character in Celtic folklore, and I got this when we were in Ireland. So I kind of went the same direction as Jorah. I feel kind of that magic connection with the Fae, and I felt that very much in Ireland when we were there. So, all right. Thank you all for playing with me.
Thank you, Hannah. And thank you for jumping in and kind of figuring that out last minute, because I know that we had thought Ezra was going to be able to do this with us, and then he got called into work. And so, yes, thank you so much. Okay, so then the last sort of official thing in our program today is to learn some more self-care, self-balancing kind of techniques. And so Nancy's going to show us how to do something amazing. So I'm going to hand this over to Nancy.
All right. Hi, everybody. I'm Nancy Lodi, Nancy Rockstar Lodi today. And I'm super excited to be part of GEMS. And my portion of this celebration is about self-care, which is the hottest topic for anybody in energy work. Would anybody agree with me on that statement? Right. So what I'd like to do is start with some self-care. You have 1 minute exactly to do what you need, whether that's go to the bathroom or refresh your tea or take a stretch. Ready? Go. All right, you got about 30 seconds left. And then when you feel complete, come on back. Just like that. That was awesome. Very well done, every person. We're going to wait just a few more seconds for people to come back from their self-care. So my first question for everybody in this kind of discussion about self-care is, how awkward did it feel to do something for yourself when I asked you to do it? Not awkward at all? You enjoyed doing it?
I took that as permission to go get chocolate for lunch, so.
So Hannah took it as permission. I gave permission for her to do something that she probably wouldn't have done if I hadn't said, get up and do it now, I'm guessing. Anybody else have a reaction to what just happened?
Well, I noticed that my head was hurting from staring at a screen all day. So I reset my head and drank mom's tea.
Awesome, awesome. So there was like self-awareness to understand what is it that I need before I go and decide to do it. Anybody else have a reaction to that? Lisa's said, well, I probably need some water, so I'm going to do that. By the way, Lisa, it's so good to see you here today. One of my good friends, Lisa. So I think the theme that we all kind of run up against is we all want to practice self-care and we all need to practice self-care, but often we don't do that thing unless we're given permission by someone or someone else. Like the instructor has built in times for a tea break, or somebody else says, well, why don't you go to the bathroom before we get started? And then we're made more aware of what our actual needs are and to step into that space. In general, in modern society, people are pushing their needs aside in order to do any number of a zillion things on every topic. And as we evolve as practitioners and as students, we're trying to step into the opposite side, where we are well aware of what we need all the time, and also really able and capable of giving ourselves permission to have that thing. So I mentioned crying earlier. In the year after my mom passed away, I just gave myself permission to cry. And that felt really, really good. Hi, Ezra. Bye, Dora, rather. And so that felt really, really good to me at that one time. And I don't know that I do it all the time, but I remember that I did that once. So my next question for you is, when you think about self-care, what does that mean and what works for you? Does anybody want to chime in with self-care things that they love, that they absolutely adore? Anybody want to chime in with that stuff? Liz?
Taking a bath, even though it means I have to clean the tub before I get in there. So part of it is like having a clean house, but then afterwards, like taking the time to just, I call it a magic bath. And I put a little essential oil and salt, and I take the time to Reiki the water before I get in. And it just, that's my favorite self-care thing that I don't do enough.
Very cool. Anybody else want to chime in with self-care things they absolutely love? Alexis?
I have sort of a ritual of the, I would think of them as the kinesiology self-care techniques. And I know that this sounds like I'm pitching classes, but it's actually much more the other way. It was like, I had taught classes for so long and told people things like, if you were to just do your switch-ons and your cross crawls every day, you would feel so great. And then I would forget between classes. And then if we go back a couple of years, like beginning of 2020, when people were really freaking out about immune system stuff, and I was really researching things about resiliency, I started getting into habits of doing a few things, the four thumps kind of thing, and some neurolymphatic things and some switch on things. And now I just do them every day. And then I feel like not only am I doing this really great thing for my body and I feel good when I do it, but I also feel like I'm much more in alignment with what I tell people. So it's a walking the talk kind of thing for me as well. Because now I'm much more comfortable with telling people, well, you should be doing these things daily, because I know that I am. So care for me and care for everyone else at the same time.
Awesome. Be the change that you want to see in the world. Awesome. Very cool. Anybody else?
Yeah. I mean, I'll just tack on real quick, because I was also going to say switch ons. And my reason is, I know that anytime I feel scrambled or I stumble over a word, I automatically go here. But more importantly, I love it as a self-care technique, because Ezra and I have friends who we've taught like just that one thing. So friends who don't, we have friends who've just taught that one thing and who haven't necessarily taken the class, and they'll do it when they are feeling like scrambled or, you know, whatever. And so I'll see someone who has no other knowledge, just like grumbly doing this because they know it works. and I love it. It makes me so happy to be able to kind of give that to other people. The other thing that I do for myself is when there is sunshine, I sit on the ground outside and I read in the sun.
Wow, that I like that one a lot.
It's good for us earthy people.
Yeah, absolutely. That's an awesome suggestion. Thank you very much, Hannah. Lisa, were you going to mention something?
Yeah, life is busy. It's hectic. It's crazy. And it's really hard to squeeze things in. And what I love to do is Nancyology at night, because I get in bed, the day is done, and it's like, oh, I can do that. I have time now. And I use priority mode to see where I need to go first and everything. And sometimes I just get through three, but it's always there. I can always do it, and I don't have to find time to do it. And it really helps. And I teach it to every one of my clients, and I encourage them to do it. Some of them, I tell them they have to do it. And it's just a wonderful gift you have given to mankind.
Oh, thank you. Awesome. Lisa's talking about my video, Nancyology, which I just put the link in the chat. These are six balances that I gleaned from Crossanology that require no muscle testing, that reset the glands and the energy system. And I had been giving them to clients for years, and not until the video came out, like 10 years later, did I actually do it for myself on a regular basis. So that was crazy. So I do that at night. Anybody else want to share something that they love to do?
I have a pretty massive misalignment in my head and neck. And so I can get to a point a day where I can just feel like my nervous system is like here. And so one of my favorite things to do is just lie down flat on the floor. And it's like, It's the biggest like deep breath and like relief that I feel in my physical body is just to, it feels like all the gravity's been taken off. Like I don't realize how much pressure, downward pressure I feel. And then I lay down and I'm like, whoa, like, oh, I can breathe. And oh, my nervous system can talk, and everything just feels so much better. And it's such a good reset. And you know, if I only have 5 minutes, then I can lay there. I quite often do stretches that I do for my neck and back as well. So that kind of goes along with it. I really, really love my stretches. If my back or neck's hurting, I can do my stretches, and it usually really lessens that. But even just the lying flat is just such a relief to my whole system.
Awesome. Very cool. Very cool. So one theme, just as we're talking here, that we are working against when it comes to self-care is having enough time to do that thing. So
Alexis mentioned that she wasn't doing those things unless she was remembering in class, and that we often have to like set aside time and prioritize some type of self-care, whatever that thing is. I like to do Donna Eden's 5-minute energy routine in the morning. I realize I don't really have time for that, so I actually do it in the shower. I do it literally while I am showering, because it's the only time I'm encapsulated enough to not have 100,000 other things I want to do. So what I think is important to understand, that I understand about self-care, what's important for me to understand about self-care, is that sometimes it's about action and sometimes it is about the lack of action, right? And specifically in the States, there is a hefty dose of guilt that goes along with taking self-care. Does anybody resonate with that statement? That when I do something that's self-care, I have a little bit of guilt. Like if I have kids, maybe I'm taking time from them, or I could be preparing something for my partner, or there's 100,000 things, yes, specifically for moms, that happen in that space. And so understanding that guilty component might be somewhere you want to look this next year. Go ahead, Maya.
Oh, yeah, sorry. I also think it's really important to look, and particularly for in the States, and I know it's not just in the States, but the structure of white supremacy and what self-care means different depending on what culture you come from, and particularly in our Black community in the United States, rest and self-care has really different political implementations, as well as in Indigenous communities and other communities that are really unique to the United States, but also can be applied to other countries depending on their racial and political makeup. And I think that, I think one of the things I think is detrimental about the oversimplification of self-care, it's like, yes, there are simple actions, but not every simple action is accessible and or is that simple for every community because of white supremacy structural systems that deny people the ability to be human.
Absolutely. Yes. That is so important. Thank you so much for interjecting that into this discussion. Some things that what could be normalized self-care are not accessible to other people who have lived in an impoverished state because of any social political climate. And that is so important to understand. Thank you so much, Maya. So when we're talking about self-care and specifically that there might be like clouds of different emotions or socioeconomic issues that prevent us from getting there, those are things to look at. But underneath that is understanding in the moment, is my self-care about action, meaning I need to take my supplement, or is it about non-action, meaning I need to sit here and chill? And that is going to be something that happens for our clients as well. If you're a practitioner of energy medicine, you've had clients where they want you to be more on top of them and give them homework because that gives them an impetus to live a better life. And other clients where you give them homework and then they never come back because they're overwhelmed. And so it is important to understand this distinction for ourselves and for the people that we're assisting. And so I have found specifically with people who cannot do homework because they're overwhelmed, to give them permission to not do anything often is the best. So what I wanted to do here is a tiny little exercise that is available to every person about self-care. So what I'd like you to do is just make sure that your seat is one that is comfortable, something where your spine is somewhat erect, and you can feel comfortable sitting here for just a moment. We are going to close the eyes in just a second. And just feel in a space that is self-care for the body. So nothing that feels tight or restricted. And then a spot where you can sit and focus the mind for just a moment. So we're all going to get in this space and take a deep breath together. And exhale together. And then go ahead and close the eyes. In yoga, we have the perfect prescription, which is these three things.
stop, become aware, and take right action. And that's what we're practicing here. The very first part, which is stop. Stop is virtually unknown in modern society. Most people jump right to action and therefore have a limited effectiveness because of the inappropriate nature of that equation. So just stopping. The next part is become aware. And so what I'd like you to become aware about right now is resistance, either in the body or the mind. So take a moment to become aware. And now we'll do the action part. So everyone will breathe in, and breathing out, release resistance. Soften around the areas that feel tight, whether it's in your body, or in your mind, or in your heart. Breathing in and releasing resistance on the exhale. So continue in this fashion for the next 5 breaths while I just remind us all, your intelligent body is made of millions of cells, each finding their balance every second. And the greatest gift you can give those cells is this gentle releasing of resistance right now. When you release resistance, they are able to find their vibration of health and vitality easily. It is built into their nature and their programming to vibrate at optimum health. And so when we release resistance, we are giving them permission and allowing for this divine process to happen. And so we'll take another deep breath here together and out. So now I want you to imagine some portion of your life that you are having resistance about and actively release resistance. That doesn't mean you accept bad things. It means you stop resisting so that things can come into alignment. Now we'll take another deep breath. And all the areas that you just freed up by releasing resistance, fill them with something you love, some amazing vibration of peace or vitality or inspiration or creativity or self-love. And now you're going to take your hand to your third eye. And while you're feeling this good vibration, tap the third eye in between the eyebrows. We're going to just alert this chakra to remember this state of lack of resistance and rather being filled up with a vibration that we like. And then we'll take the hands over the heart, one hand on top of each, the other hand, the hands on top of the heart. And we'll breathe in and breathe out.
And then open the eyes. And there's your self-care for today.
Awesome. Thank you so much. I don't know about everyone else, but I had a lot of like shoulder, neck kind of tension happening on one side earlier, and I can feel a physical change in pain and range of motion just from that last little bit. Mia?
Yeah, thank you. I love doing the kind of exercise. It was wonderful. Thank you. And I want to be really clear, because I think that, and I just really feel it in my spirit, I literally pulled over to say it. It's not about poverty. I want to be really clear when I say white supremacy structural systems and the impact they have, particularly in the States, but it's global, on brown and black bodies and the denial of their humanity. And when we consider what self-care means, that is a part of this story. And as practitioners, it's really important for us to embrace and understand and bring ourselves to those places that are uncomfortable. A short example is a friend of mine who's 42, is her fourth child, had a scheduled cesarean. Many complications happened, but three of the things that happened that are undeniably what happened to Black women that go in to give birth and why the death rate is so high for Black women in having birth in the United States is that they did not give her, the cesarean ended up being vertical instead of horizontal, which wasn't scheduled and she didn't know about until 10 minutes before she was going under. And she didn't go completely under. She then did not get the morphine because she's allergic to opioids, and also found out that they gave her fentanyl because she's allergic to opioids without her permission during the surgery. They then was consistently harassed around trying to nurse her daughter and take care of her daughter and care for her. And well, her partner, her husband, had to go home because there were three other kids at home. So he couldn't be there to advocate the whole time. And this is a common story. And if she hadn't been aware of that and hadn't been somebody who was a practitioner of medicine in practice and warded and set up and like put out the like alert, hey, protect us while we're here, she could have really gone sideways, right? And she up to the point where she may have lost her life or may have lost her daughter. And her daughter has O positive blood. So on top of everything else, her daughter has a type of blood that is very sought after. That is what I mean. And this is somebody who works a salary job, is, you know, a community leader, has like private insurance. This is not somebody who's impoverished. It doesn't matter under white supremacy structural systems, whether you're impoverished or not. This is what her experience was. And so when we consider what does it mean to be caring for ourselves, I think that is part of that conversation. And it doesn't necessarily mean we have to like make point fingers, but I feel like it's very important and it felt on my spirit to be really clear about when we're talking about this, who are we including in the room, whether they're there or not, and how do we hold that, and how do we give that justice? And so what that came up for me was this sense of like, we really need to hold that levity of justice and care that is not provided as practitioners.
Absolutely. Yes, 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 yes. Thank you for naming that, Mia. That's so important. And yeah, it's something that in our mission here in the college, that's something that I'm holding close to my mission, is to incorporate that aspect into the community that we're building, the ability to meet the needs of different practitioners and people that we're serving. And I definitely would love to continue the discussion with you, Mia, because I think the college could really use a whole lot of that in our so if you have the time or the capacity, let's definitely connect about that. Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what I'm, sorry, go ahead.
I was saying definitely.
Thank you.
What I'm hearing from what you're saying, Mia, like I would love for this to be a bigger conversation than what we, you know, today we had like 30 minutes dedicated to being able to look at some kind of little self-care routine. This is a big conversation. So maybe we can make arrangements at some point to set this up as one of our like special guest study hall open forum kind of spaces. We can talk about that later, but yes, just so that we are making sure that we have the understanding and the capacity to work with everyone who's coming to our door, and also to just be able to support people at the best of our ability. Thank you. Okay. That kind of takes us to the end of the time that we allotted for this. I want to point out the reason why we sort of set a 90-minute cap for this was to make it easy for people, you know, who have limited time. We know everyone's busy. And so we wanted to kind of keep it short and sweet. But anybody who wants to stay and stick around and hang out and talk for a minute. Oh, yeah, Liz.
I just wanted to, before anyone signs off, I'm teaching yoga tonight. It's at 7, so it's like in 4.5 hours from now. And it's a free class, and I'll just be leading. We'll do lots of self-balancing, and it's like chair, and it's very kind of simple yoga. It's nothing too complex. So if you want to come, send me a message. I'll send you the link, and you can send the link to anyone else. It's free tonight. Sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to get that in before we...
I was absolutely going to plug it because that's what we're all doing this evening. So I hope people can join us. And as Hannah mentioned before, if anybody... Yes, Kate, you should. It'll be 6 o'clock. Oh, no, wait a minute. It'll be 4 o'clock in your time zone, I think. Yeah. Okay. Yes, it's a wonderful blend of yoga and breath work and touch for health and five element theory. And it brings in all of the stuff that we love to do. So it's really great. And even someone like me who's like, I've never really done yoga. It never really appealed to me. I like this class. So just tossing that out there. The other thing that I want to mention is that there are so many interesting things that are coming up this year. If you looked on the website, there's lots of great classes and things coming up. But one thing that we are doing brand new this week that we're excited about, and so we just want to put it out there for you, is we're starting our Anatomy Physiology Club on Wednesday. And this is going to be a really easy, gentle way of people getting a little more education about anatomy and physiology, because instead of having to sign up for, you know, a college semester in order to get that information, it's just going to be an hour a week, interactive. And the way that the class is structured is a lot of like people come in with what they're curious about, what they're reading about, what systems they're interested in right now, what are you seeing with your clients, what are you working on with yourself, and being able to work with both the physical and the energetic kind of simultaneously. So hopefully that appeals to some of you. This first class, we're just going to be trying it out. It's free. You are welcome to come. You can register for that on the website, and we'll make sure that everybody gets the link for it before Wednesday. And yes, anybody who wants to stay and just hang out and chat and have a cup of tea with us is welcome to for a few minutes after we turn this off. But I'm going to turn off the recording in a moment here. So the yeah. You know, that bit goes on the website, and this is just us. Hannah?
Yes, last things I wanted to mention was one, for the people who are interested in instructor memberships or talking more about us working with you in your classes. We're absolutely interested, and I really do want to kind of work on that instructor network, because there are students and people need this work, and I really want us to be able to have that. And the other thing, it was simply that I am going to be putting more classes on the website in the next little bit. Kasia Rashwa, who was here earlier, has a couple of Akashic Records workshops coming up, and I've got Touch for Health classes, and so if anyone has other things to go in the schedule, let's talk about it, okay?
Very glad to meet you, Mia. Seeing your notes in the chat. Yes, let's keep talking.
Thank you, right. Mia.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone who came. And just here's to another year.
Yay.